Yep, I'm wearing sunglasses inside. But not just any sunglasses. These are audio sunglasses. And they're not even that good. Hey, what's up? Andrew here, and these are the Bose Audio sunglasses. They come in a few different styles to choose from, and these are the tenor style to be exact. Audio sunglasses are fairly new, but there are already lots of options out there. So let's talk about these ones and who these are really for. First of all, I love Bose. I have their QC35 noise canceling headphones and the SoundLink Revolve Plus Bluetooth speaker you see behind me. And now I have the Bose Tenor audio sunglasses. Bose makes speakers, good ones at that. So how are their sunglasses? Well, first let's talk about exactly what they are. They are mediocre sunglasses that connect to your phone through Bluetooth with speakers built into the arms. These ones connect using Bluetooth 5.1, resulting in a battery that will last roughly 5.5 hours on a single charge and will charge up in only about an hour. You do have to use this specific charging cable, which does magnetically attach. Still, I always prefer that everything use USB-C, but that's just not the case here. There is a speaker in each arm, and I presume a battery in both as well. Dual beamforming microphones allow you to take phone calls and even control your phone's voice assistant. On that, my first impressions were that they are kind of heavy. I mean, for sunglasses. I had to weigh my Oakley sunglasses just for comparison. My Oakley flak jackets are about 0.9 ounces, where the Bose come in at 1.76 ounces, so just about double the weight. Through my testing, I have never felt like the weight ever really became a factor, but I have to believe that if used regularly, then the weight may wear on you. Like most other Bose products, they feel like a quality product. Very well built and not fragile in the least. The speakers in these are pretty small, as you can see, but put out plenty of sound. I mean, they don't have to be that loud as they are right on top of your ears. They are right above your ears, to be exact. So your ears are still open to hear the sounds of the environment around you. This is known as open ear headphone design. They are actual speakers. These are not something like the bone conducting headphones like the Aftershocks. Bone conducting headphones will actually channel the sound to your ears through vibrations. These two designs are both known as open ear headphones because they allow you to hear your surroundings. I have not tested any kind of bone conducting headphones, so I can't speak to the quality of the sound. These though, the sound is right where you might expect it to be from a premier speaker manufacturer. By that I mean, the sound is very clear. No distortion when the volume is all the way up or even really down low. The only thing I think they lack is bass, to no surprise. With open ear design, you're left without any kind of enclosed space for the sound to reverberate. So you're not going to get that deep bass sound you might want. There are some controls on the frames themselves. There is a single power button to turn them on or off or play, pause your music. There's also a sensor inside that detects motion. So if they haven't moved in a preset amount of time, they can auto power off. Or you can simply place them upside down on the table to power them off. Other than that, there is a touch area on the right side that allows you to control the volume by sliding, and you can even press and hold to hail Siri. I was actually surprised how well the touch area worked to control the volume. It worked really well. I never had an issue finding the area with my finger, and the sensitivity felt pretty natural. Bose does have an app you can download to your phone as well to help you configure some of the options on these. For some reason, there is a different app for these frames than the one I already have for my headphones and Bluetooth speaker over there. For those, I used the Bose Connect app. Then I went to set these up and was prompted to download the Bose Music app. No idea why there's two separate apps. They offer the same experience, but kinda dumb that there's two apps I need to use now. Like I mentioned, in the app, you can configure options like enabling the auto power off, managing the Bluetooth connections, and there's even a useful area of tips on how to use your frames. This is handy when you first set them up so you know exactly how to control them. These Bose audio sunglasses come in at around 200 bucks, but like I mentioned, there is plenty of other choices out there already, like the Amazon Echo frames, or even the recently released Soundcore frames. Each having their own pros and cons, I'm sure, like the ability to hail Alexa from the Echo frames, or the customizability and styling of the new Soundcore frames, which you can also try on with AR using the Soundcore app. These I have not been able to get my hands on yet, but I am hoping to so I can compare them to the Bose. I am very intrigued by those. All of these options fall into the same $200 area, with likely deals to be had during the holiday season. I'll leave links below to all of these if you want to go check them out for yourself, so look in the video description for that. So, okay, that rounds up what these are and how, well, kind of underwhelming they are too. But who are these really for? Or why would you want to even buy these? If you think you know when you might like a pair of these, let me know down in the comments. I'm curious if anyone is actually looking for something like this. I tried to think of the times I wear sunglasses. Would I want these for driving? Maybe not. I have one of those fancy cars with a radio in it, so that wouldn't make much sense. What about when I'm playing sports? Not a time I need to listen to music or take a phone call hands-free, so that's not it. I did take my dog for a walk today, and it was sunny, so that's actually a good use case. But then again, we're getting into winter here, and I had to put a hat on, which covered up the speakers. This was interesting though. I thought when I put a winter hat on over these that the audio would be muffled. I'm clearly impacting the open ear design that these were probably calibrated for. But to my surprise, it actually improved the sound. This makes sense as this made the speaker area more enclosed, allowing for that reverberation. And I can even notice some increased bass. Well, buying these just to walk my dog doesn't seem to do it. So what else? What if I'm just out and about and need to make a call or want to listen to some music? This is where things get a little weird to me, if not awkward. I mean, the speakers are open to the air, meaning there is zero privacy. People that are nearby will be able to hear what's going on, whether you're listening to music, your favorite controversial political podcast, or just trying to have a private phone conversation about what the heck an NFT is. Also, you're probably not buying these to wear them on an airplane. I guess in the end, I can't find what practical purpose these actually serve. My recommendation would be instead to spend your $200 on a solid pair of wireless earbuds instead, like the AirPods Pro or Beats Fit Pro, which I recently reviewed. I'll leave a link down in the description for that too if you want to go check that out. But then again, it's tech, and these are kind of fun. So I'm embracing innovation and going to hope that these continue to get better, because why the heck not? They are kind of already getting better. I am still intrigued by the design of the new Soundcore frames and can't wait to try those out when I'm walking my dog, I guess. Hey, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet and like this video. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.